Previously on The Walking Dead. So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government'll start handing out shots and the National Guard'll do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
Me.
He's hungry. I guess he knows it's feeding time. You know, your sister said she wouldn't mind doing this.
Roman, we've talked about this. Becca doesn't need to deal with this kind of thing.
Listen, I know you think that giving her an easy life is what's best, but it's really not.
I was just asking Clementine if she knows who the man on her radio is. It's okay, honey. You can tell us.
Go ahead, Clem. It's okay. You're not in any trouble.
It's just a friend. I don't think he wants to hurt us.
What has he been saying to you? What have you been saying to him?
I told him I was trying to find my parents and that they were in Savannah. He really seems nice. I think he wants to help me find them.
Kinda looks like Duck, don't he?
It's just a kid. What the hell happened to him?
I don't know if I can, Lee. Couldn't do it before. Can't do it now.
It was me.
Huh?
I was the one giving the bandits supplies.
What?
It's all my fault.
Everybody, run!
Ben!
No, Ben, help her! God damn it! Hey!
Lee, what's going on?
I saw someone standing there by the fence, watching us.
A walker?
No, too fast. Took off like a bat out of hell when I spotted him.
Was it a man or a woman?
Didn't get a good enough look.
What does it matter?
I'm wondering if it's the same guy who's been following us. The guy on the radio.
Kenny?
I'm fine. I'm fine. What's all the ruckus?
Lee saw someone watching us from outside the gate.
What? Who?
I can't be sure.
They ran off before I could get a good look.
I don't like this one bit. Not one bit.
Me either. Walkers are one thing, but the thought of someone out there actually stalking us.
All right, that's it. We've stuck around here long enough. It's time to get back on track. Time to get down to the river and find ourselves a boat.
I don't know if Omid's well enough to move yet.
Well, he better get ready, because I'm going down to River Street right now to find a boat. And as soon as she's ready to go, we're moving out.
We only checked the house to make sure it's secure. We didn't really toss the place. We're low on food, water, meds, ammo. We should make sure there's nothing here we can use before we move out.
Well, you search it if you wanna. I'm done with this house. We came to this city to find a boat, and that's just what I'm gonna do.
Maybe it's not such a bad idea to check the place
one more. I said I'm done with this house!
We can do both. Ben, you take one last look around the place. Grab anything that looks useful, while me and Kenny go down to the river to get us a boat.
Wait, can't I come? My mom and dad can't be far now. Maybe we can look for them on the way to the river.
Clem, honey, I think it'd be best if you stayed here with Ben. I need you to watch out for Omid and Krista. Help them get ready to move out.
You said I'm supposed to always stay close to you.
I know, it's just this once. Sometimes we all have to put aside what we want for the good of the group. Hey, don't worry. I'll be back before you know it, okay?
Okay.
Daylight's burning. Gonna go grab my gear, then we'll head out.
Come on, Clem. Let's go see if Omid needs anything.
So, you're just gonna leave me on the bench here?
No offense, Ben, but I'd feel safer if you stayed here.
How am I supposed to not take offense to that? What am I, a liability? Great. Just great. Thanks a lot for the vote of confidence.
Confidence is earned, Ben. And you've got a long way to go to earn yours back after some of the stuff you've pulled. You feel me?
Yeah. Yeah, I feel you.
Stands on golden sand and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond the sea. She's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms.
Son of a bitch. That bastard's fucking with us again. It's another trap.
No, listen. That's not the same bell as before. This one's further off. Whatever it is, it's gonna get the dead moving over there.
What in the hell is going on?
The person ringing that bell might be doing us a favor.
Whatever, man. I find whoever's doing that, I'll ring their motherfucking bell for them.
Good one.
Let's keep moving.
Still nothing moving behind us. I think we're... Oh, my God.
There's gotta be a boat. There's gotta be.
Are you sure about that? Doesn't look like it to me. Maybe we need to start thinking about a plan B.
This is the plan! It's the only one we've got, and you pissing on it in front of everyone like you did back at the house ain't exactly helping. Screw you. I ain't giving up that easy.
You hold your every breath. Life is for the living in the water.
This one might still be salvageable.
You better be right about this.
I said it might be. Give me a fucking break. I'm a fishing captain, not a miracle worker. I'll check it out. You look further along the waterfront. Maybe there's something at the other end.
I don't think we should split up too far.
We don't have to. See that telescope? You can see all the way along the waterfront from right here. See what you can find.
Okay.
The heart's above the line, above the line. We vow your life and blood. This is not our home. Oh. Yeah, I hope you never found it. Try and keep your way.
Fuck. Is this meant to be some kind of warning? Or do something like this.
Against the time of struggle, skin wearing. Against the time of struggle, to keep our heads above the deep.
Great. Needs a quarter to work.
Our hearts above the line. Above the line. Who we are today, never make amends for what we've done.
It's tainted blood. Yeah, that would have been too easy.
And his eyes are full of love. Forgive them.
Looks like it's still intact.
Against the tide.
Looks
struggling.
Like this thing has been stripped clean.
Skin wearing. Against the tide, we struggle to keep our heads above the deep, and our hearts above the line. Above the line.
What the hell are these markings? They're all over the place.
Fuck!
What's up with the boat?
It ain't gonna work. Hull's cracked beneath the waterline, plus someone stripped out the battery.
You can't fix it?
What the hell is that?
Fate worse than death.
Come here, everyone.
Shit.
Come on, we gotta find Roman.
All of this for you. All the spoils of a wasted life. All of this for you.
Until the Memorial Bridge. Can't imagine how many people tried to escape across it when the city started to fall. Nothing but water, not a boat to be seen. What the hell? Get down! Get down!
Why the hell are we hiding?
Someone came down from that building at the end of the street.
Where'd he go?
Saw him run into that newsstand.
Could be our bell ringer. How about we go find out?
Maybe he's just another scavenger like us.
Yeah, and maybe he ain't. Maybe he's that fucker on the radio who's been messing with Clementine's head. Don't you want to know? Because I want to know. Okay, you head up the middle of the street. I'll go around the side, cover your flank. We'll come up on him quiet, take him by surprise.
We just want to talk to this guy.
Oh, we're gonna talk.
You're not from Crawford.
Crawford? What the hell are you talking about? Kenny, don't! No, he's with us!
How are you people?
Kenny, back off. Unless you want this lady to give you another ass-whooping.
Who are you calling lady? The name's Molly.
Molly? I'm Lee. This is Kenny and Clementine. We're not looking for any trouble.
Hi.
You guys really aren't from Crawford, are you?
No, I'm from Macon. Kenny here's from Florida.
She didn't ask for our life stories, Lee. What's the deal with this Crawford place?
You sure you want to know? When everything started going to shit, some people got together and sealed off that whole neighborhood. Folks willing to do anything to stay alive, stop the dead getting in. I try to avoid them.
Why?
Let's just say they have a zero-tolerance policy for anyone who won't, or can't, live by their rules.
So how'd you know we weren't them?
Because there are no children in Crawford. Not anymore.
What do you mean, no children? Why not?
No children, no elderly, no one with an advanced medical condition. Basically, no one who might be a burden on the community. Crawford's all about the survival of the fittest. That's how they survived, while the rest of the world went to shit around them.
Jesus Christ.
Well,
Just the opposite, when you think about it.
But still, children, you're not seeing me.
In God's name, why?
No one stays in Crawford unless they can pull their own weight. Otherwise, you're just another mouth to feed, another drain on their precious resources.
What does that mean, pull their own weight?
It just means being able to help out, like you do all the time.
Doesn't sound like any kind of way to live to me.
Couldn't agree more.
How do you know all this?
Everyone in Savannah knew. What was going on inside Crawford got passed around like a ghost story. Except this one was true.
Do you know who's been ringing those bells all over town?
Yeah, that would be me.
I knew it! Lee, I knew she was the one who's been following us! Fucking with us!
Get that finger out of my face, Grandpa, before I jam it straight up your ass. I haven't been following you. I don't even know who the hell you people are.
Calm down, Kenny. The voice on the radio was a guy, remember?
Yeah, well, whoever you are, ringing those bells this morning nearly got us all killed. Raise the dead all around us.
That's the idea, genius. It's how I get around. I ring a bell in one neighborhood to attract the local geeks towards it. Buys me some time to scavenge the areas they cleared out.
Geeks? Is that what you call them?
Yeah, you know, like at the carnival? They'll eat anything, alive or dead.
That was pretty smart, the bells.
Doesn't take much to outsmart the dead. Bunch of dumbasses. You just gotta move fast, get in and out before they start to wander back again. Look, I'm gonna ask you people again. You're not from Crawford, so who the hell are you? What are you doing here?
Came down here looking for a bomb, hoping to get our people out of here and find someplace safe.
Yeah, good luck with that. Anyone with a boat took it out of here as soon as people started eating each other. Any that got left behind, Crawford stripped them for parts. Cars, too.
There's gotta be something.
If there was, do you think I'd still be here? I've been over every inch of this city. This whole place is picked clean.
God damn it! Fuck!
Hey, moron. You wanna keep your voice down?
Shit.
Since you're not getting on any boat, I'd advise you folks to go back to where you came from before. Great. Just great.
Isn't that the... Fuck. Gunshot must have brought him back.
Isn't there another way back to the house?
Mom, is there a... You're just gonna leave us here?
Sorry, I must have missed that part of our conversation where you became my problem.
Don't leave us here, please.
Come on, make it fast.
Fuck me.
Come on, hurry.
Watchdogs caught him trying to steal supplies.
Is he bitten?
No, they didn't get that close.
What did he take?
Food, medicine, whatever he could get his hands on.
Usual stuff. I couldn't get any other information out of him. I don't think he speaks English.
I can't believe he just snuck in.
Second break-in we've had in the last couple of weeks. Last time we couldn't catch him, and they got away with more medicine than we could afford to lose.
Well, we all know what it's like trying to survive out there. He just came in here for food. Let's just give him some and send him
but
on his
what
way.
What if there are more of them? He could have been scouting.
now, Lee! Get your ass out of there!
God! Can't get it open!
Here, use that to pry it open.
One for himself. You deserve better, old man.
Fuck!
What the hell? Must have been one of those old nuclear fallout shelters. Look at all this. It's enough to keep people alive for months.